Reports accompany and shape decisions at all organization levels, from work groups and local businesses to national policymaking groups. As you can see from that quote, analytical reports are a common form of communication in the technical workplace. Typically, analytical reports respond to a research question, and they often make recommendations. There are several types of analytical reports: empirical research reports, completion reports, recommendation reports, and feasibility reports. Analytical reports are arranged according to the IMRaD pattern. This pattern follows the steps of the scientific method and includes the following sections: the introduction, the methods, the results, and a discussion. You can adapt this pattern to meet the needs of your specific writing project. You may choose to also include a conclusion or recommendations. In the rest of this video, we'll discuss these IMRaD sections using examples from this student report. This student addresses the problem of the declining number of volunteers in a state park program. Notice the clear and descriptive title of this student's report. We'll begin with the introduction. The introduction should establish the context of your work and explain the problem being researched. Here we see the author begins the introduction with general background information on the topic. It's important to narrow the background information to a specific topic. Often you'll need to review previous literature so you can place your study within a context. Many times this is described as a literature review. After the specific subject is identified, the author states the problem being researched and the purpose of the study. You can also include a forecast of the report's organization. The methods section follows the introduction. This section describes the steps that were used to obtain the information. By explaining the general research approach and the specific steps you used, you allow your readers to assess the reliability of the results and to design a similar project. In the results section, there are two points to remember. First, present your results concisely and without interpretation. Second, use visuals to support your results whenever possible. In this sample, the student used a table to illustrate the results of a coding analysis. In the discussion section, analyze and interpret your results. Explain how the information you've gathered addresses the research problem that you stated in the introduction. Remember that sometimes your findings don't address the problem. If so, explain why. The discussion is your chance to explain the connections between your data and your research problem. It's a good idea to include a section to explain any potential weaknesses of your study design. In a conclusion, you can re-stress the problem and present major conclusions not given in the discussion section or that you want to emphasize. You can also communicate the larger implications of the results. Depending on the type of analytical report you are writing, you might include recommendations. If you use them, list recommendations that logically follow from your results and discussion. Recommendations typically look to the future. The IMRaD pattern is a common and recognizable format and is a good starting point for writing analytical reports. It helps explain how to share the information you've gathered to address a specific problem.